What's up, y'all? It's me, Rio. Today we are actually back in my room like we're doing the usual. All right, now good news is one, my brother's little Bob Ross pop socket came in, and two, we got Stitch with a sombrero next to me, and three, I also got a brand new chair. It's actually really comfortable. It doesn't feel like I'm getting needles in my back now. My brother is actually working the camera. Gabriel, say hi. I don't know if you can hear him yet, but today we are actually going to be talking about Captain Marvel. Got an opportunity to go ahead and watch it with my family. Shout out to the Cinemark app for my free ticket. And other than that, let's get it popping. So, regardless of what type of, I guess, flack is going around with like Brie Larson and how she didn't like white men or some mess like that. Look, I didn't care about that. Me personally, I tried to stay as far away as I could from that. But the thing that I did enjoy personally were the actors actually in the movie. In the trailers, I don't know if you guys remember, but Captain Marvel herself, she kind of acted bland, so to speak. Well, at least that's what it came across as. But actually in the movie, I love her banter. I love her sarcasm that she has with every single character. With Fury, because she is with Fury for most of the part of the movie that is not a spoiler. And I think that just the change that we got, the change in tone from the trailer to the actual movie, I thought that was really, really solid and really, really cool. I dug that a lot. Now, actually for Fury. So, seeing Samuel Jackson, he is back as a young Nick Fury for this movie. And knowing what I know about, you know, phase one, phase two, and all of that going on with Fury, it's so good. It's so good to see him kind of be oblivious to a bunch of these different things. Because remember, he is experiencing all of these aliens and things like that. He's experimenting them for the first time. And it genuinely kind of just warms my heart a little bit, because he's so innocent to everything. And I think that that right there, it's really, really cool and shows some quality character development. So I want to go ahead and mention one person out of, you know, the cast as well, is actually Goose the Cat. Now, if you have already watched the movie, you kind of feel what I understand about how the dynamic between the cat and then Fury, right? But in my opinion, he does steal the scenes that he's in. He steals them a little bit, but I personally don't think that he outshines everybody else like how a lot of people on the internet do. And I think that just kind of seeing that adorable like nature throughout the entirety of the movie adds more. And on top of that too, I'm not gonna say exactly what it is, but one of the cutscenes is pretty funny. It kind of just adds on to the humor of Goose the Cat as well. Now, I want to go ahead and actually give a shout out to, hold on, let me look at my notes. Anna Boden and Ryan Fleck. So these two are actually indie movie directors. This is their first time, I believe, directing a multi-million dollar movie. And I think that they did well. There was a few things that I thought were a little off, maybe some lighting in some places, just in some different shots, but I mean, that's just me kind of nitpicking, at least on that side. Now, with every good, there is some stuff that is, I don't want to say bad or like terrible or whatever, but it's something that I just didn't enjoy, and this is what they are. Now, this movie does have a twist or two. I will let you guys know that it does have a twist or two, but do I think that these twists were played out perfectly? No. I think they're great ideas, they just weren't exactly the best whenever it came to execution of said twist. Personally, one thing that I thought was missing was a lot more lore that had to deal with the Skrulls as well as the Kree. It's because you don't really get the best insight in their war. You kind of just get like, oh, one side hates one side, and one side hates the other side. They don't like each other, they're fighting. You don't get enough of that out. And I do understand that Captain Marvel is the main character. I get that, yes. But isn't she like a lot more of a pivotal piece in this war? So, like, it just makes me wonder, like, what could have they taken out? What could they have cut out of the movie in order to add more of the lore? What could they have done in order to try to flush out and make you care a little bit more about the dynamic that happens between everybody? And that's just me being kind of nitpicky, but I mean, it's something that has to be talked about because it is in the movie. Now, some of the last things that I have to say is that personally, the movie itself, it's a solid movie. Yeah, I mean, it isn't, in my opinion, I don't think it's the best one in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, but if you are going into this movie and watching it and you haven't really watched a lot of the cinematic universe, you'll see it as a much better movie than somebody who has kind of watched them, kind of just at this point, you know what I'm saying? But that is my opinion. Like how I said, I don't like to give like too hardcore ratings because I ain't about that, because then people start fighting. Next thing you know, I got Marvel fanboys coming from ahead, and I don't want that. So on that note, I hope you guys have a good rest of y'all's day. And right before I leave, I want to say one thing, that there's another strong woman in another universe, and her name is Wonder Woman. Personally, I think Wonder Woman is a better movie.